This is the part 2 video of how to use table in Jasper, or tabular report you can say. So now the finished thing, what we are going to do, we are going to delete all the unnecessary things. As usual, we'll press Control and select all the unnecessary thing, and we will delete. So we have deleted each and everything. Now we have summary. We will increase the height of summary to 400. If it's okay. And now we will put, now we will make one tabular report. From here, palettes, from palettes in basic elements, you will find this below cross tab, you will find table, you will go select this and then click on it and then drag and drop. Please select or build the data set that you want. So existing data set, I'm not able to select. So data set 1, you can rename data set as well. Then sample JDBC, cancel, provide query. So, okay, what happened? So provide query. So here table, and in table we will select product or something like that. In last video we were doing order, so we will go with order only. Select star from order. Next, it will give you number fields you want in table. Select all. And do you want to group your table? I think no, then skip it. Use JDBC, master data, something like that. Click table columns. So you have to select whatever the column you want. I am selecting all. And now in this one, first of all, we will select by default everything and see what we are going to get. It will take some time. So it takes some time, and then you will get this. Hopefully we can increase. See, you can see now it's by default 200. You can increase the width from here. Like suppose you want 400 width, you will increase. Or the other way is to, you select here, increase this, you will get increases. And then what you can do, you have these elements. You see, you will get now from main report to tabular elements. So you will get this. Do you want this header? This part you want? I think table header, we don't want table header. So either we can go here and select here, delete the row. So table header is gone. This is one way of doing it. Now what we don't want, we don't want this colon footer, we don't want. Go here, delete it. Now what we don't want, table footer we don't want. Go and delete the row. Okay, now we have what we have in table. Table we have in detail section, we have column, and other thing we have is colon header. So colon header and details in table we have. Okay, now can we resize this? Obviously we can do it, that is not a problem. We have resized it. Now what will be the default size of all this? So what we will do, we will press CTRL and or maybe shift and select this. All got selected, shift, all got selected, with shift and then click on an element. Then width it is showing 14. I don't want only 14, so I will make this 130. Okay, I got the issue. So now what was happening, like you have to first increase the colon width. So in header you have to go and increase the colon width, that you can do shift and select all. Everything is selected, but yeah, this is a problem. Then the other way what we can do, we can go here, CTRL, select these, select this, go row by row. Are there? I have selected everything in appearance, vertical layer, cells width. So cells width we want to increase. What we will do, right now it is 14, we want 140. Now see, all the cells width has automatically increased. Okay, now you can see like its size is little bit not up to the mark, so you have to make it like this. So 140 into 14, it should be. And now go to main element. See, so you have to increase the page width as well. So go here, go into page format. Page format, what it should be. So you can open calculator as well to take help to make your calculation very easy. 140 into 14, so what, 1900, so make it 2000. So what I am going to do, I will make it 2000. And boom, hopefully it will fit. It will fit. Okay, so it is fitting. Now what I can do, I can preview it and see if I'm getting tabular report or not. And if we are getting, that is well and good, that is very interesting. So see, we got tabular report, and how many pages? So this is the way in which you can create a tabular report. So this is an important thing. Last one was also important, the kind of mistake we do while creating a tabular report and things like that. Suppose you want to make this beautiful, then what you need to do, you can go here, click here, you will go in table, and in table you can select this element. All this you need to select, and okay, suppose I want every text into center, middle, then I will do that. If I want bold, I will make it bold. Other thing, if I want like transparent, I will make this transparent. And background color, if I want, I can make it anything, brown. Four color, if brown, then four colors should be white. Then 6F, you can put here 6F, and you will see now this is a customized report. Okay, and now if you will see, it will be a really beautiful report when you compare to the last stuff. And see, your border has been, now suppose this is not colored, what could be the reason? This not get selected. So go into the report, how to debug, that is also we are learning side by side. And we'll go and make sure here, go here, so check the background color, copy this and go here, transparent uncheck, then background color, you will paste the color code of that, click OK, make it center, make it center, align. And for color you want white, should not be black. So this is what you can do, and it is done. Now if you want to do a specific formatting for date or time or anything, you can do that as well. So suppose you want everything to be center aligned or left aligned based on your requirement, so if you want everything to be center aligned in the middle, then you can do that. If you want this to be italic, you can do that, but italic will not look good. And you can get this particular report like this. So this is your basic report. See, now you can see this, you are not liking because it is so many things, so there is a fix to this one as well. So you will go frighten, right, we will select this, right? We will go into text, okay, text box, pattern, you will go, okay, written expression, text box. Expression, pattern expression, you can select here in pattern, okay, go here in pattern, then number, you want 2 decimal, you will get something like this. You want leading 0 and decimal, you want 2 decimal, you will finish this. So here the pattern is before, and now see the magic. Go there and check. So now you are getting only 2 decimal places. So these are the stuff that you can do in Jasper. Suppose here you are getting SIP reason as a null. You don't want null to be displayed. You can select SIP reason. SIP reason, where is this SIP reason? Okay. Go in text, and you can tick this blank when null, and then see the magic. Obviously, like SIP reason should be null will not be displayed. See, now whatever the null we used to see in our report, now that got vanished. You can put some other stuff in place of null as well. So this is the thing. From here you will export as a PDF. Give an example, you are getting exported. That's all guys for now. I think, hope you guys liked it. Don't forget to show your questions in comment box. You can ask me question if you want something to be covered. Obviously, I would love to cover that particular stuff. So that's all guys. Hope you like my content, and bye.